We welcome you to ESPN's College Football Primetime. They've been playing football in Nevada since 1896. You ask around these parts, they won't hesitate to say this is the most significant game ever here. Number 4 Boise, 10-0. Nevada ranked 19th in the country. They are 10-1, and they meet up tonight. Good evening, everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore, as always, joined by my partner, Rod Gilmore. It has been a cold, snow-filled Thanksgiving week here in Reno, but things are heating up with BCS talk. There's so much on the line for the Broncos.
Well, really, ever since they beat Virginia Tech back in September, everybody thought Boise State would be in this position, a chance to play for the national championship. And, you know, Oregon took care of business today, it looks like, and Auburn did. Now, Boise State is poised to jump TCU if they can beat Nevada tonight. That'll put them in position to continue to stalk Oregon and Auburn for the national championship and make them the leader heading towards the Rose Bowl.
You look around the country offensively and you notice that the pistol offense has become a popular trend. It all started here at Nevada, and they've got the perfect fit at quarterback for it with Colin Kaepernick.
Yeah, you know those great plans that Boise State has? This guy could derail those plans. I mean, he's an outstanding player, great, great runner, has had a great career doing that, but he's also really developed the passing and test. He's a great passer now.
Kaepernick closing in on major records. He has 55 rushing touchdowns. Most rushing touchdowns by a quarterback in college football history, 59 by Heisman winner Eric Crouchin. See, Cap is two away from tying Tim Tebow for second. As a dual threat, just 110 rushing yards away from joining Brad Smith as the only two players to ever pass for 8,000, rush for 4,000 in a career. And as for this year, well, he's close to becoming the third ever to pass for 3,000 yards and run for 1,000 yards in a single season. Vince Young, Dan Lefebvre, they were the first to do that. Coach Chris Ault, he's already in the Hall of Fame, 26 years now at Nevada, the creator of the pistol offense. And Chris Peterson, two-time National Coach of the Year in just 5 seasons at Boise. Boise State won the toss deferred, so Nevada will receive. Mike Ball, just a sophomore already, Nevada's career kick return leader. Khalid Wooten also back deep. Trevor Harmon to get the game started, kicking off for the Broncos. And here is Ball. Flag comes down as Ball is able to get it out to the 33-yard line, taken down by Jerron Johnson.
Receiving team during the run back, 10-yard penalty, first down.
And there is the 6'6" senior from California, Colin Kaepernick. You know, this has been a year where everybody's been so wowed by all these great quarterbacks, these dual threat stars, and Cam Newton. But you look at Kaepernick's stats here, right? Closing in on 1,000 rushing yards, 2,400 passing, the 19 touchdown passes, outstanding.
Well, he's called this the biggest game of his career.
Four yards back in that pistol formation. They start with Vitale, and Tower with a good gainer out across the 30, taken down by Darrell Avery.
That's a very good running offense. They can also throw the ball. One of their key guys, Vitale, in the backfield. Virgil Green, excellent tight end, can get down the field, and really great blocking on the perimeter to open things up for Kaepernick. That offensive line, Barker, very good. Bender, big guy, big offensive line.
Tawa again. And he's going to be close to that line to make, maybe just short according to the mark, as Chase Baker was in on the tackle.
You know, Tess, that Boise State defense, underrated, really making an impact this season, and really their safeties are highlighted tonight. Jerron Johnson, one of those guys responsible for keeping Kaepernick really in check when he gets to the edge, likes to run. The other guy, George Iloka, those safeties did a tremendous job on Kaepernick last year, really handled him in the first half. This year, Kaepernick has to find a way to break out.
Impact players brought to you by Tommy Hilfiger. Here is Cap. And he is cut down close to that first down line by Darrell Acree. And the mark gives them the first down.
And Akre is part of that outstanding defense. He stepped in for Byron Hout last week. Hout out with a foot injury. Akre was a former starter. He has stepped in, and they haven't missed a beat yet.
So a first down for Kaepernick and company. Tower now. Gain of two on the play. That front seven for Boise is so active. Venable and Tevis coming in there.
Well, here's that great Boise defense we've talked about. Everybody knows about Winterswijk. Win. Chase Baker, really underrated, doesn't get a lot of attention. Shea McClellan may be having really a defensive player kind of a year season. We've talked about Akre. Tevis has speed over there. Secondary will get challenged tonight. They love to play man-to-man coverage on the back end.
Wimberly in motion. Kaepernick to pass for the first time tonight. And he's able to get it complete to Rashard Matthews. Matthews is a receiver that Coach Olt said he has to have a big game.
Well, this is what we talked about. The man coverage. Single coverage on the outside. Thompson working against him. And a perfect seams seven route and out route. Saw them working on that all week. They want to take advantage of that man coverage. And Kaepernick put the ball right on the money.
Now Mike Bell joins Hightower in the backfield for Coach Alt. And Kaepernick wants to talk things. So back to business on first down. Tower. A loss of one. Ryan Winterswijk, Winston Venable, quick to get to Vitawa.
Now, one of the things that we learned from the Nevada players, mostly their seniors have never beaten Boise State. Kaepernick said, a lot of pressure, big game. He would feel unfulfilled if he left here without beating Boise State.
Putting some pressure on himself. Second and 11 now. Kaepernick being chased. Gets rid of it. And was that intercepted? What a play by George Iloka. Wow, what a play. Off the hands of Virgil Green, and Iloka comes up with it right on that sideline.
Well, that ball was thrown pretty hard. Watch Green here, doesn't come up with it, but watch the deflection. Left hand, left foot, right foot in bounds. And that's a safety, Iloka, coming up with the pick there. That is a fantastic catch. Great concentration in the right place at the right time.
So Kellen Moore and the Boise offense out there, and the officials are going to take a timeout to discuss this.
The previous play is under further review.
So replay official Ken Lucida will get to work here taking a look at what Iloka was able to accomplish on the sideline.
Well, by now you know the standard. Once it's been called on the field, you need indisputable video evidence to overturn it, and you're looking for possession and control there. He goes to the ground. Ball never touches the ground. And the first look we saw, left foot was in, right foot was in. As long as that ball doesn't touch the ground there, he's got two hands underneath it, cradles it. That's a catch. That is really tremendous concentration by George Iloka. Young man who left high school early out of Houston, came over to Boise.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Interception, first down.
So it stands up. And that allows for us to take our first look at Kellen Moore tonight. The best pure passing quarterback in college football, is passer rating number one in the country, could be on course to have the all-time highest passer rating ever recorded in the modern era of the game. Starts with Doug Martin in the backfield. And here is Martin. Straight up the middle. Martin out to the 21-yard line as he was taken down by Brent Roy.
Very familiar with this offense. We've seen their skill at wide receiver. Titus Young, very speedy. Pettis, great body control. Martin is the running back who gives you yards after contact. Kyle Efah, very, very good tight end they use in the passing attack. And that big line up front, Nate Potter is the NFL prospect. Thomas Byrd, probably the shortest center in college football, but one of the best.
Moore steps up in the pocket and gets a complete to Titus Young, who has the first down yardage. Titus Young, 41 straight games now with a catch.
This defense will be challenged up front. Dante Moak, outstanding pass rusher. They'll try to run the ball at him. Colson is very good on the other side. The linebackers in their 4-3 set. James Michael Johnson inside, very, very good at sifting out running plays. The back end is where they have had some issues. Folks have gone after them. They've tested them deep in the secondary.
Screen to Young. And that quick burst by Titus Young out to midfield. Boy, in about two strides, he's able to get upfield in an instant.
Well, it's that speed and quickness, that dimension that really opens up Boise State's offense. This is just a bubble screen. Give him some space and let him run. And he can do that.
20 yards for Titus Young.
Tess, this offense is very good at the play action pass and throwing the ball down the field.
Play action, here it is. He's going to take a shot looking for Young. Overthrows him. Young was covered well that time by Marlon Johnson and Isaiah Frye.
Well, you know what the thing is about this offense and Chris Peterson. They believe in being in attack mode early. They start fast. They want to get out there and stun you, confuse you, and make you disorganized. And you have to remember, Chris Peterson grew up in the Bay Area, went to UC Davis, watched Bill Walsh, understood that whole philosophy, and adopted that.
Here's Mitch Burrows. Good blocking out in front. Mitch Burrows drives ahead to the 34-yard line. Another first down by Boise. Austin Pettis and Tyler Shoemaker blocking for their fellow receiver.
Test, they script their plays just like Walsh. They test you. They want to see where you're going to be, how you react, how you cover things. They want to create confusion so that when that defense goes to the sideline, they're asking their coaches, what's going on? They want to really get you off your game right off the bat.
So another first down for the Broncos. Here's Martin. And Doug Martin with hard running down to the 26-yard line, tackled by Kalen Burnett. Doug Martin, the junior, had 128 yards last year against Nevada. He is a real hard runner.
A lot of yards after contact. A very physical runner. Just as content to run over you as to try and run around you.
Dan Hall, the fullback, now in the backfield with Martin on second and two. The pitch, Martin. And he has the first down and still driving ahead to the 22. They moved the chains again. Zach Madonick with the tackle that time.
Was that 4 yards after contact that
Indeed.
Time? An arm tackle is just not going to take him down. You feel the pace, the sense of urgency with this offense. Defense on its heels a little bit.
By the way, you will see at times number 98 Ryan Winterswijk even come in and play some fullback, the defensive end. He's in on this Doug Martin run to the 20. That time the Nevada front four got to him, led by Ryan Colson.
And it continues. They come in on a second down, changing personnel. They will shift, they will move. They're going along the script, testing the Nevada coaching staff. How do they react? What do they see? What matchups do they get?
Second and seven now for Kellen Moore. Moore with time and able to connect to Gabe Linehan to the 14-yard line. It'll bring up a third down.
This team has been money inside the red zone, 71%. And you know, the standard gold is 80, but hardly anybody gets that. Anything over 70% is excellent in the red zone, and it's about touchdowns. It's not about kicking field goals. It's about getting touchdowns.
Third and two. As they often do, changing the formation. Linehan in motion. Pressure. Martin unable to shake free. What a good play by Duke Williams, the strong safety for the Wolfpack.
That was an excellent tackle by Duke Williams. He gets one-on-one in space with Martin and makes the tackle, driving him back. They got the matchup they wanted offensively. Ball just a little bit behind, a little bit late coming out, and Martin had no chance as Duke Williams closed quickly.
So a 33-yard attempt for Kyle Brochman, the WAC Special Teams Player of the Week. Last week he was 3 for 3. And he puts it through. First down. Doug Martin trying to find some running room. Not much happening against that Wolfpack front four. James Michael Johnson filling that hole.
Well, Tess, Boise State usually starts fast, but it's been limited tonight. 3-0. Brodsman had a 33-yard field goal. George Iloka got a pick. Stopped a Kaepernick drive. Kaepernick was 2 of 3 throwing the football. He has not tried to run the ball much yet.
Ball now in motion, the fullback. Martin again getting a lot of work early on. Here is Doug Martin. And Ryan Coulson and Kevin Grimes corral them.
This is the area of the field where Moore tends to look to Austin Pettis. Pettis has great size at 6'3", great body control, can make acrobatic catches, can lean on smaller defensive backs, and Moore tends to look for him down here.
He's their all-time reception leader. Third and nine, pressure comes. First down, Jeremy Avery out of the backfield.
Shades of last year. Last year, Nevada blew assignments on 4 occasions with running backs, fullbacks coming out of the backfield and left them wide open. And it happened again.
Doug Martin in pass protection picked up Marlon Johnson and gave Moore just enough time to get that to Avery. 16 yards on 3rd and 9. Martin fights his way inside the 5.
You know, Tess, that issue of not covering backs out of the backfield is really a linebacker issue, safety linebacker issue. They lose the guy who's in the backfield. You count receivers from the outside in, and usually linebackers and safeties pick up the second or third guy inside, and if they lose him, he's wide open.
Jeremy Avery is often that guy who gets lost, isn't he?
Yes.
He has a knack for that. 2nd and goal. Here's Martin. Gets free and into the end zone. 3 would-be tacklers. Doug Martin kept his balance, and Boise scores their first touchdown of the night.
And we talk about yards after contact with him. Watch the yards after contact. 1 missed tackle, a 2nd, a 3rd. All the yards came after he'd been hit.
And Kyle Brochman, now 227 career PATs. Here is the play action. Pettis in stride, ball came loose.
You know, this team loves to attack you when they have you on the ropes. Just an inside route by Pettis, crossing the field, the ball right on the money. That's about the only time you'll ever see him drop that ball. As Dante Moak was back there, that's a defensive end. Talk about speed and quickness and athleticism. He got back there to make that play.
That's remarkable.
Yep, outstanding.
Jeremy Avery now in the backfield with Kellen Moore. Here's Pettis. Tries to wiggle free, taken down at the 40-yard line by Doyle Miller.
But Kellen Moore is such an effortless passer. Everything is compact, smooth, tight, comes out easily. No wasted motion, no big windup, just perfect darts.
Very relaxed and efficient. And now here you go, Rod.
Yep. Go Wildcat.
Moore splits out as Avery is the Wildcat quarterback. And Avery surges ahead for the first down. Jeremy Avery has had at least a touchdown in 6 of the last 7 games.
He is the change of pace running back. He is not the powerful guy. He is the quick change of direction, I will get around you guy.
And remember DJ Harper, who was one of their featured backs, injured and out. He was averaging almost 9 yards a carry as their go-to guy. Avery now in the I formation. Gets the pitch. And Avery is wrapped up that time. Brett Roy and James Michael Johnson.
The Nevada has done a good job defensively of keeping Titus Young in front of them. One of their concerns coming in was making sure that Young didn't get behind them and they didn't give up a big play early on. And they have sacrificed short throws and a little bit of run defense to make sure they don't give up that big play.
They go with Avery behind center for a direct snap again. This time he gives to Martin. And Doug Martin has a first down for the Broncos. Hard hit by Ryan Colson.
You know, when you go to that Wildcat formation, you sort of balance up the defense because now your quarterback is a player. He is a blocker or a runner. So you actually have one extra blocker. In a traditional offense, your quarterback is always out of the play. So you're playing 9 on 11. And now you get yourself back in there, one more guy.
How about that hit by Colson?
Colson's a real player, man.
And now Moore back under center. First down for the Broncos. Going for Titus Young. Touchdown, Boise.
Well, they caught him in man coverage. We had just talked about the fact that Nevada was playing deep. They were not playing man coverage. They didn't want that. But Fry this time gets hooked up with Young in single coverage, and Moore will always find it. He found the weakness and he went to it right away.
29th touchdown pass of the year for Kellen Moore, for one of his favorite targets. And Brotsman puts it through. See, 6 plays going 48 yards. Young with the touchdown catch. So Boise State has scored now on all 3 possessions. Field goal after the interception, and then the Doug Martin touchdown, and then that beauty by Kellen Moore to Titus Young.
Remember we talked about the start, how they confuse you, they test you, they script, they find out what you're doing. After they've done that on that opening drive, they come back and they go field goal, touchdown, touchdown. They figure it out, they roll you, and now you're on your heels.
And here's Mike Ball. Ball out to the 29. Let's check in with David Diaz and Fonte.
Hey guys, offensive line coach James Spady talking to that group up front led by John Bender is telling them they have got to pick up the line stunts. Boise State's trying to tee off on them. More importantly, they got to get back to doing what they are, and that's running the football. Got to try and dominate the line of scrimmage.
David, you're absolutely right. The one thing I've noticed they haven't done, they have not gotten Kaepernick to the outside, and they've thrown it. But he's a missing part of that offense. When he's not running to the outside, you lose a lot of what they do offensively.
Kaepernick to pass. Going downfield, looking for Matthews, and he comes up with it. Rashard Matthews, boy, they needed a big play, and Kaepernick delivered it.
Yes, he did, and Matthews delivered it. Matthews did a nice job on Thompson of actually kind of separating. This ball is a little underthrown. He gets single coverage, and Matthews works Thompson a little bit, just a little shove to get a little distance, and comes up with that ball. And they need this. They need to get back in the game now.
By Tower. Tower with just a gain of two that time. 47-yard reception, the longest pass allowed by Boise's defense this season.
Well, they figured out right now in Nevada that they can work the man coverage to the outside. They're not trying to throw the ball down the middle. There's a safety hanging around the middle. They're playing man coverage, outside, inside technique, outside guy available, so they're throwing to the outside.
Kaepernick. And here goes Matthews. Touchdown, Nevada. Brandon Thompson missed on the play. Rashard Matthews brought it in. Take a look here at the sideline, Rod. Does he step out?
Oh, he was Cadillacing and not paying attention.
He was looking casual.
Oh, my goodness. He had no reason to let that happen. There was nobody threatening him. He took it easy, a little style, a little flash, and that touchdown will come back. Wow. He stepped out of bounds.
Stepped out at the five. So instead of a seven, it's first and goal.
You know, it's simple.
First choice timeout in the first half. This is a 30-second timeout.
So first and goal now. Tower muscles his way in.
Team on that left side. Great blocking over there. Great job done up front on that left side by Matt Slater. 72 over there.
Anthony Martinez tacks on the extra point. Doug Martin got the night going for Boise to put them up 10-0. That hard-earned touchdown run. Then Kellen Moore to Titus Young, 17-0. It was turning into a typical Boise game. But after a couple good receptions by Matthews, by Tawa, puts Nevada on the board for the first time tonight.
That was a huge answer for Nevada's offense.
17-7, number four against number 19 with BCS Bowl implications. Titus Young looking for room. Young cuts back, and a flag comes in at the end of that return.
Illegal block in the back. Number 24.
Boise will be backed up, celebrating its 6 years sponsoring Good Hands Field Goal Nets. Allstate makes contributions to participating universities, general scholarship funds. For each field goal and extra point kick, to date, Allstate has contributed more than $2.4 million in scholarship monies.
This Boise State offensive line has had a little trouble with Dante Moak and his speed getting into the backfield.
Number 55, the nation's active leader in tackles for loss, has 60 and a half. Martin cuts back, and a good choice as he goes for 9 yards there, finding that hole. So much on the line tonight. Of course, it was such an interesting day With all the emotion going on, the comeback by Auburn, many around our hotel packed with Boise fans and the team, they were sitting there with their jaws dropped on that Auburn comeback, thinking maybe they could be playing for a national title spot tonight. And then Arizona hanging early with Oregon before the Ducks go out there and cruise to an impressive victory. And now Moore finds a wide open Austin Pettis. Pettis out to midfield. Ball comes loose at the end.
I think he got it back.
A scramble for it. I believe he did.
I think he got it back. Good ball handling by Moore as he fakes things and allows Pettis to come back across the middle. And a good hit again by Colson.
How about these defensive ends getting downfield against wide receivers?
And a nice scramble by Pettis to get back on that football. As Colson really delivered a blow.
Colson and Moak, 20, 25 yards downfield at the end of some of these plays. Martin now to the near side. Blockers in front. Doug Martin. Here he goes. Watch out. Doug Martin. Score it. 51-yard touchdown run.
Well, they did something we thought they wouldn't do. They brought a blitz. They caught him inside with the blitz. They had no safety there. Kyle Efall with a great block on the edge. And that was all she wrote. But you see the blitz coming up the middle inside. And they catch him. They get Martin to the outside. Perfect call at the perfect time. Catching Grimes coming in inside with the blitz. And Johnson, number 8. They get around them.
Just 3 plays and 81 seconds after Nevada thinks they've got some momentum and they score, Boise comes right back. 51-yard touchdown run.
Hey, Tess, we didn't think they would do this. They were so afraid of things that bringing a blitz was not the thing you would get from these guys. That they would not try that at all. They brought the blitz inside and the sweep comes outside. Kyle Efall, 80, with a great block. They caught them inside. They were so deathly afraid of Titus's young speed that Nevada seemed like they would stay away from the blitz. But they got caught with it that time and they really got burned with that.
You know, these top 4 teams in the country, these undefeated teams that are contending for the national title and or Rose Bowl position in years, in the case with these non-AQs, they all have something that they're so great at. You got Oregon's fast offense. Auburn has the best player in college football. Yep. TCU with the defense.
Yep.
But when you watch Boise week in and week out, the one thing you take away, it's the most complete team in every aspect. They're so balanced in every way, Rob.
I think that's absolutely right. I think most people would agree with that when they watch them.
Here's Wooten now. Wooten's trying to get to the outside, and he is wrapped up at the 24. And right now, Wisconsin is number 7 in the BCS. Kaepernick. He was looking for his tight end, Virgil Green.
I really think Virgil Green is a huge part of this offense. He has the ability to get down the field. And when he blocks in space on the edge, he really helps Kaepernick make big plays.
Kaepernick passing out of the pistol now and looking for his favorite target and finding Rishard Matthews. Matthew's already playing a big role tonight.
Well, we watched Kaepernick in practice yesterday. An unusual day before practice.
They go full.
Full. They had shoulder pads, helmets, and they went for 2 hours. And that's normal for them. You don't find teams that do that, but they did that. And he threw the ball well yesterday.
By the way, Matthew's already 133 yards. What an impressive first half for the junior receiver. First down toss now. This time he's able to connect to Wimberly.
Now the thing you notice about Kaepernick and the way they use him, he's got such a strong arm. Those long outs, those 7 routes, those corner routes, those are things that he throws very well because he has such a strong arm.
young man who is a Major League Baseball draft pick. And the Cubs pitching prospect. Well, he's football through and through. Now with time on second and three, looking for running room. Instead, he tries to get it to Matthews. You know, with Kaepernick's speed, once he gets outside those tackles, he's very dangerous that time, choosing to throw.
I would encourage him to run when he gets outside like that. Now, you talked about that arm, you know, that fastball, 90-plus miles an hour. He was such a good baseball player that it scared off a lot of football coaches. He only had one offer coming out of high school, and that was from Nevada. You see that he's become less of a sidearm baseball thrower, more of an over-the-top guy with touch, and his accuracy has improved.
Now facing a third and three. And they go with the fly sweep. And coming up short is Shepard, as Winston Venable once again so fast to get to the ball.
Yeah, well, you know, we talked about it, Tess. They're using those safeties. You know, Venable, Johnson, Iloka, they're hanging out on the edge. They don't want anything outside. They're forcing everything inside. And Venable keeps his leverage and makes that play. They are inviting Nevada to run the dive, to run inside, and they're telling them, no way are you gonna we're gonna let you run to the outside.
So Langley back on to punt. Mitch Burrows at the 15. And he calls for the fair catch, and it settles in at the 12. Good adjustment at the half for Auburn. And now Martin. Doug Martin just gets those shoulder pads down, muscles ahead. So this was the scene earlier today. Everybody here in Reno wanted to see what happened. The last play, you see the reaction of the Boise State fans. And we were staying at the team hotel, a hotel packed, a casino resort here in Reno that was packed with Boise fans. And hey, you talk to people in the elevators. Oh, what happened? Can you believe Alabama lost that lead?
That's Reno, what was saying. Reno was a complete football town today. No question about it.
Here's Martin again. Good block in front by Dan Paul, his fullback. And he's able to pick up a yard past that first down line to make. Now, a football town today and a football town tonight as they are hosting what nobody hesitates to say is the biggest game in the history of Nevada football.
Well, you're coming down to it. I mean, you've got Oregon at one, Auburn at two, Boise State with the win, poised to jump over TCU and become number three. And then next weekend, it will all shake out.
Chris Ault pacing the sidelines. He knows what a tough task this is, and they've been in this position of being down big against Boise before as Martin tries to wrestle free for a yard. It's happened in recent years as Nevada has given up leads. They were down 27-3 last year and rallied back. They were down 24-3 in 08 and rallied back.
That man has been a workhorse in the first half.
Big half for Doug Martin. 24-7 for the fourth ranked team in the country. Doug Martin, 137 rushing yards and a couple of scores in that first half. Of course, that Boise defense has been stellar all year long as well. So Boise set to receive here to start off this second half. And here is Titus Young. Oh, and Young takes a big hit down there at the 22-yard line. That was Albert Rossetti. Let's check in with David.
Hey, guys, I had a chance to talk to Coach Ault coming out after halftime. He talked about they have to find a way to shut down the running game of Boise State. Doug Martin, 137 yards in the first half. Missed tackles, and got to play with better leverage. Also, they got to find a way to convert on short yardage situations to keep their drives alive.
Thanks, Dave. You know, Nevada has gone down this road before with Boise of trailing early, rallying back. But they have to stop this Boise offense to have a chance. Here's Martin. This time only a couple. Ryan Colson was quick to get to Martin.
The problem with stopping the Boise State run game for them is that they're going to have to bring an extra guy in to help, a safety. And when you get that eighth guy in there, now you're leaving Titus Young in single coverage or Pettis and an open zone area underneath to work, and they'll throw the ball on you. That's the dilemma Nevada is facing by trying to stop the run.
Kellen Moore will just slice you up if that plays out. Here is Pettis in motion on second and eight. Titus Young now. Good blocks in front. Look at how fast Titus Young is. Those first couple of steps and he is off.
Well, he's explosive. And that's why he is probably the top NFL prospect on this Boise State team. So quick, so explosive, translates well to the next level. A step and he's at full speed.
Good block that time by Burroughs as well as Pettis. So a first down out to the 38. Martin gives a little and adds on to his total to the night as he's out to the 44-yard line. Colson finally wrapped him up. But Martin with 144 yards.
Well, I want to know how many after contact on that run. That was another 3 yards after contact. Talking about a guy who goes at about 5'9 and 212 pounds.
You got the power back in Martin, and now you see the speed back with Avery. Here's Burroughs. Takes advantage of the block, and he's out past midfield. And how quick was Kellen Moore to just get rid of that ball?
He saw it out of the corner of his eye. He saw the defender on the right side tip that he was coming, and Moore knew right away. Look at the right side. And now he looks over and he sees his man Burroughs right there. He says, well, I'll just throw it to Mitch Burroughs. That's where the blitz is coming from. They can't cover him.
There is just a football intelligence with Kellen Moore.
You're talking about a guy who bought the Boise State playbooks when he was in high school.
Oh, there's some great stories about how obsessed he was with formations and play calling in high school. And here to the near side now is Avery. James Michael Johnson ran him down. Of course, this game of such importance. You look at those BCS standings, and Rod, obviously playing number 19 tonight. Boise expected with a win tonight to launch past TCU. Oregon and Auburn took care of business today.
Well, Boise State has been stalking TCU the last 3 weeks or so, cutting their lead in half every week. It's clear if they win tonight, they will move beyond TCU when the standings come out on Sunday.
Second and eight. Moore over the middle, and that should have been caught. Mitch Burroughs hit him in the chest. Made a good effort to get to it, but then didn't secure it. Dante Moak had the pressure on Moore.
And Tess, the importance of being in that third spot in the BCS for a non-AQ means that you are first in line to go to the Rose Bowl if Oregon winds up in the national championship game.
That's right. The Rose is obligated to take the top qualifier from the BCS non-AQ when it loses one of its anchor teams to the title game. Could be the case with Oregon. Third and eight now. Moore launching it for Titus Young. Right through his hands. Moore took a shot. Doyle Miller had the coverage. Young couldn't connect with it.
Well, Miller did a nice job of really kind of just pushing and stressing Young down the field. He stays with him. Little contact there. Gets his hand in there. Nothing worth flagging him about. And Young couldn't come up with it. But
and here on fourth down, Kellen Moore staying on the field.
Well, he can kick it too.
Yeah, he has had those pooch punts. So a timeout called by Coach Chris Ault. Nevada will talk things over. Kendall Hunter, the running back, all offense there with the pokes. And now out of the backfield is Ball. And Mike Ball maintaining his balance to the 35-yard line.
Really nice touch by Kaepernick. He put that ball in a spot where Ball did not have to break stride, didn't have to turn around, just able to keep heading up the field. Perfectly thrown.
So Colin Kaepernick has the Wolfpack marching here, 35-yard line, facing a third down and one. Tawa stacked up. Billy Wynn collapsed him. Yeah. Chase Baker underneath him.
Yeah, Wynn 6'4", 288. And it starts right here, right there and right there. Watch all the penetration they get. 90 and 97. Wynn is 90. 97 Baker. They just stuffed everything right up front.
And now going for it here on fourth and two. Kaepernick incomplete. Flag comes in. Jamar Taylor was covering Wimberly. Dramatic play with that big pass protection block, and then Kaepernick lofting it up downfield and getting the penalty to float in was Wimberly.
Pass interference. Number 21 defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic.
Well, they tried to move the pocket. They wanted to get Kaepernick to the edge. And look at the protection he gets. How about Vitale with that block? That allows Kaepernick to get to the edge. And there was pass interference down there. You see Taylor not look back until late. Had his hands on the receiver out there, Wimberly. And you, when you're engaged like that and the ball is in the air, they're going to get you flat.
Vitale, a military pressed Winston Venable.
Good call.
And Cap just throws this away as Shepard, the wide receiver, was covered well by George Iloka. So no opportunity for Kaepernick to go that direction.
You know, Kaepernick has to be frustrated. We have not seen him, the long strider, the guy that we've seen all season breaking these 20-plus yard runs time and time again. You know, this is what he's done against Boise State. They've gotten better against him every year. 2007, he just blew him up, and they've ratcheted it down with their safeties each year after that.
Straight up the middle with Mike Ball. Colin Kaepernick without a positive rushing yard tonight. That is remarkable.
Yeah. Yeah, he's one of the premier dual threat quarterbacks in the land. And this Boise State defense has eliminated part of that. They're not letting him run the football.
He's been going through the air looking for Matthews, who has 156 yards receiving. Tower's been doing the job on the ground. And right now they need 6 yards. They need to cash in here, try to cut into this lead. Pressure off the edge. Can he escape it? He does. Gonna run for it. First down inside the 10. Kaepernick, touchdown, Nevada.
Is he in bounds? Left in. Right in. Ball on the pylon. He's in there.
6'6", fast as could be. And he goes airborne to the pylon to cut into this lead. We got ourselves a ball game. Nevada. Flag came in at the end of that PAT.
Personal foul, leaping number 92 of the defense.
That is Shea McClellan. He was trying to get after that extra point. A local columnist called this the biggest sporting event in Reno since heavyweight champ Jack Johnson fought here back in 1910. Start of the fourth, and they only trail Boise now by 10. Our coverage spotlight brought to you by Travelers Insurance.
Well, the Boise State defense did a great job covering Colin Kaepernick almost all night. Kept him contained until he broke containment on a scramble, a broken play, got outside for an 18-yard touchdown run that energized the crowd, energized his teammates, and put Nevada right back in the ball game as their defense stood up to the Boise State offense.
Start of the fourth. Kaepernick to Ball. And Mike Ball loses his footing out of bounds, lost the ball as he was going out of bounds, and out at the 40-yard line.
Yeah, this is the first time since, maybe early September, that Boise State has been challenged in the second half. Most of their games have been over by midway through the third quarter.
Well, they haven't trailed an opponent since the fourth quarter of that opening game against Virginia Tech. They have been nothing but blowouts, but this Nevada team, ranked 19th with a high-powered offense. And whistles come in, flag comes in.
Before the ball can be snapped, false start. Number 67, offense, 5-yard penalty. First down. Third down, correction.
This is a Nevada offense that's third in the country in total offense. They average 537 yards, and they have a defense with, as we've seen, fast playmakers.
Yeah, but a long time since Boise State had gone into a fourth quarter with a game in doubt. And that's a different kind of pressure. That's a different kind of situation to deal with.
So a timeout called by Boise State, 69-67, and you see what's happened the past 3 years between these teams.
Well, these seniors have not beaten Boise State, and they feel like they get closer all the time, and that this is supposed to be their year.
Third and seven now for the Wolfpack. Pressure as they set up the screen by Tala, and Tala has the first down, and he works his way out to the 48-yard line.
You know, Tess, when you've been beaten by a team for a couple of years, but you keep getting closer, that confidence starts to grow. You are no longer intimidated by who they are, their helmets, or anything. You start to believe that you missed a play or two the year before. If you make the play or two this time, you get the win.
A lot of reason for Nevada to be confident about themselves. By Tala. And Tala out to the 44. Cross midfield. McClellan and Johnson finally got to him.
Here you see the eyes of Colin Kaepernick reading the action of the defensive end, the defensive line, as to whether to give that football or keep it. And most of the night he's had to keep it because Boise State wants him to give it. I mean, to give it. They don't want him to keep it and go outside.
Matthews. And Rashard Matthews spinning free. Here he goes.
Green, 85, that tight end we talked about who makes great blocks, got in there and disrupted everything.
Virgil Green took out two defenders.
Man.
Straight up the middle again. Let's go down to the field to Dave.
After that last Nevada possession, defensive back coach Marcel Yates had the group up together talking to the guys going, hey, missed tackles, PIs, that is not who we are. We have to play with great eyes and finish plays.
They do indeed. And Courtney Randall getting some work now.
There is a big difference in having to focus and concentrate for 40 plays as opposed to 70 plays.
Hightower and Colin Kaepernick, you see they are the greatest running combo now in college football history, overtaking the Pony Express from SMU. And he picks up the first down. So Dickerson and Craig James, number two all time now to Kaepernick and Tawa.
Right now, Kaepernick and Tawa are getting it done by Tawa inside. Kaepernick, they still haven't been able to get him outside, but the reverse was a nice substitute, and it opened up things inside again.
And the downfield throwing to Rashard Matthews. Here he goes now, Kaepernick. Slides down to the 49-yard line. That clock continues to count down. A competitive fourth quarter for Boise, Rod. They are not conditioned to this.
It's been a long time. It's been a long time. And like I said, when you're trying to focus for 40 plays, that's a lot different than 65 or 70 plays. Game's usually over by mid-third quarter. Not tonight.
Kellen Moore's been pulled in third quarters from wearing that baseball cap a lot. There's Randall and Courtney Randall bulldozes ahead for another Nevada first down. Randall again. Ball comes loose. Nevada appears to have recovered. I believe Virgil Green, the tight end, was trailing that play. That's the second time tonight that a Nevada receiver has been in the right place at the right time, if indeed he has the ball in the bottom of that pile.
Yeah, Virgil Green has had a great night. He's really a tremendous blocker. And he is
next upfield, the other tight end who actually comes up with it.
Yeah, you're right. Sudfeld, 44.
Both of the tight ends were in on that ball. Sudfeld and Green, and it was Sudfeld who comes up with it. So a second and three. Kaepernick to the outside. Colin Kaepernick gets free for a first down, and Nevada is marching. Good block that time by Mike Ball.
Here's the guy. That's the guy that they want to use as the lead blocker. That's Virgil Green. He gets out there and seals off the inside and let Kaepernick get outside. That is what they use him for, to screen Kaepernick.
Vitawa. And Tawa to the 16-yard line. Now this is the Nevada offense that we've seen all year long. Remember, this is an offense that had 844 yards in a game a few weeks ago. They average 537, third in the country. Great running attack.
And they've done this on the ground. Kaepernick has not really had to throw it this drive other than a screen pass.
Kaepernick keeps it. He's taken down at the 10-yard line.
And that's the adjustment to get him to the edge. They're using Green as a lead blocker to block the guy who would be responsible for Kaepernick on that option. and Green has done a great job of it. Now you've got the full effect of Colin Kaepernick.
All 10 plays on this drive have been rushes. Third and one. First down, Nevada. And it'll be first and goal. The clock continues to run down. The BCS hopes for Boise, trying to stay alive, Rose Bowl contention, trying to move up the rankings, trying to stay alive and in position for BCS title hopes. But this Nevada team, this is their moment. Gets it to Mike Ball. And Ball is forced out by Winston Venable.
Well, they don't particularly like to throw the ball down here. They like to go with more option with two backs and get to their triple option down here. And it looks like that's the formation they're going to use. They're going to go with two tight ends and two backs. And that usually means more option, more outside option down here for Nevada.
Second and goal. Towers stacked up.
Yeah, see, now they've got some difficulty because they don't have enough room to run their passing attack that they like. And Colin Kaepernick has a strong arm, but he's not a touch passer in this red zone area. So I don't expect him to throw the ball unless they throw a fade. I'm thinking more option again, and maybe with the pitch involved this time.
We'll see if that's the direction they go here. It'll be third and goal. Looking to take the lead against the fourth ranked team in the country. Kaepernick off the fingertips. He was trying to get it to Mike Ball coming out of the backfield.
Yeah, they came with the option look and the option pitch look, but then just wound up throwing it instead of the pitch aspect of it. And they had it out there, and the Kaepernicks are watching, and they knew, Teresa and Rick knew, that they had a shot there.
So on comes Anthony Martinez. Remember, the wrap on him, he kicks a low blow. Ball had one blocked earlier. This from 23. Greeno is rocking. Joe Tessitore, Rod Gilmore, and David Diaz Infante with you. Number 4 and number 19 tied up 24-24. Boise's 24-game win streak on the line, as are BCS Bowl implications. The Rose Bowl trying to keep alive title hopes. It all comes down to this.
They're chasing Oregon and Auburn, and TCU is looking to stay in the hunt.
Titus Young from the goal line. And Young is pushed back at the 20. Set it up to Martin. Doug Martin. Look at Doug Martin go. Puts on a move, and Martin still on his feet. Doug Martin, could he? Yes! Was that a Rose Bowl run? What a play by Doug Martin, 79 yards!
It was a screen pass in response to all the pressure, and look how many guys he makes missed tackles. Three guys had shots, and instead of running over them, he juked around them.
And now can Boise pass their test? The other two did. Kaepernick, look at the time he has here on 3rd and 6. And he gets it complete for the first down as Virgil Green secured the ball.
We've seen Virgil Green do some great blocking, and now he's coming up with catches. Plenty of time for Kaepernick. I thought he would take off, but he is thinking about the easier play now and getting his guys involved.
And now Vitala shakes loose, and Tala with a 9-yard run.
I really think it's been such a long time for this defense to have to play inspired fourth quarter football. They may be a little gassed.
And this is the time in most games when the reserves are in, when Boise's usually up by multiple touchdowns and coasting for another win. But the 19th ranked team here at home on senior night, they are inspired. Second and one. Towel. He's going to be short of that line to make as Darryl Akery, the middle linebacker, came around to track him.
Really good speed that time by the defense. Akery, Iloka chasing that down from inside out.
Remember, Byron Hout, their fine linebacker, is out for the remainder of the year with a broken foot, so Akery stepping up in a spot like this. Third and one now. Tala, first down, Nevada. And clock will count down. Vitala has put together a fine night, 116 yards, 25th career 100-yard game, the NCAA's active leader in 100-yard rushing games.
You know, they have a shot they can take. When they have Green in that wing position, they can get him down the field.
Kaepernick tries to avoid the pressure, and he'll just throw this ball away as Ryan Winterswijk, the Broncos defensive end, was trying to get to Kaepernick.
Very smart play. He knew he had nothing to the left side. The play was to the right side. That's where he wanted to go deep. But once he got flushed out of the pocket, he knew the right play was just to get rid of the football.
There's Winterswijk. Senior from California has had an outstanding career. Just over 2 minutes to try to defend this 7-point lead and keep Boise's BCS hopes alive.
A lot of heavy breathing out there.
Second and 10. Here's Ball setting up the screen. Mike Ball. Ball is free, and Mike Ball has it down to the 30-yard line. A 22-yard screen to the reserve running back.
He's explosive. He is the guy they look to for speed out of the backfield, and they had that set up perfectly to the right side. He slipped out, got one good block, and just full steam ahead.
Kaepernick patiently taking his time to set things up. Fresh set of downs. Vitala, blockers in front, cuts back. Just a gain of about 2.5. Chase Baker and J.C. Percy trying to find Vitala.
They were gassed.
Matthews to that corner. And right on that pylon of that first down line. And a first down for Nevada inside the 20.
Well, he's working against Thompson, who was laying way, way off. Way too far in that part of the field to be laying that far off. Easy outtake there.
Just over a minute to go. A minute 16. Nevada looking for that touchdown to tie up this game. Vitala straight up the middle. They have a great sense of themselves, don't they, Rod? They know what they're all about.
Yes. Yes, they do. And the game plan is straightforward. Vitala inside, take the out route when they give it to you with the man coverage, and then try and find a way to get Kaepernick or someone else to the edge when you can.
Now Courtney Randall comes in as a future back. Randall gets the call. Courtney Randall, another first down. Clock stops with 42 seconds to play. It'll be first and goal. Chris Peterson, all that talk of the BCS, title game hopes, Rose Bowl berth. Could Nevada tie this game? Put the pressure on Boise. Send it to overtime.
Clock is running.
First and goal.
I don't like the way they managed that time.
Not at all. A lot of time went by. Remember, when it stopped at 42 seconds, and now at 21, and you can see the disgust in the face of the Hall of Fame coach.
This changes everything. I mean, now you've got no timeouts. Now you have to be really cautious about what you do. Because if you run the ball inside and you can't get back up, you can't get another shot at it.
Undoubtedly.
You have issues now. Now you have to think about throwing the football because you used the timeout and you burned about 20 seconds you didn't have to burn.
They were so committed to that running game and it brought them right down the field. But then the mismanagement there and then the last sequence and burning that timeout.
That is absolutely critical. Boise State with the BCS Bowl berth on the line. They are trying to stay in contention with Auburn and Oregon for the national championship, trying to jump ahead of TCU this weekend to be in the prime position to go to the Rose Bowl if they do not make it to the national championship game.
Folks in Fort Worth, great interest in this. Kaepernick to pass. Matthews unable to connect. The coverage came from Brandon Thompson. That leaves 17 seconds.
Well, and you know that as a defensive back now, you know they have to throw and you want your eyes on the quarterback. And you see Thompson get his eyes back around there quickly. Now everyone on that defense understands it's about throwing the football. Nevada cannot take the risk that if they run, they don't get into the end zone and they don't get another playoff.
No timeouts, 17 seconds, play clock under 10. Matthews to the near side, split wide for Kaepernick. Play clock at 2. Touchdown, Nevada! Rashard Matthews does it again!
Rick and Teresa watching, they get it. They're enthused. Chris Peterson is not.
All week long, they've talked about this, saying it's the biggest sporting event in Reno since the heavyweight champion Jack Johnson beat Jim Jeffries in 1910. The biggest game in the history of Nevada football. Third best team that they've had in this era of modern college football. Ranked 19th with a high-powered offense and going up against Boise, who have been the kings of the WAC. A year ago, Titus Young returned one against Nevada. They'll be kicking off here with 13 seconds to go. Keep it on the ground. Young will have his chance. And he's forced out at about the 37-yard line with 9 seconds to play.
You would assume that Kellen Moore will take a shot at trying to pick up some pretty good yards with one play. They have a timeout, so they can actually use the field and see if they get something out of it.
Now Kyle Brotsman has a career long of 52 yards. steps up, airs it out, looking for Titus Young. Did he catch it? Diving catch with 1 second to go. Unbelievable. He supermanned and velcroed it. How in the world did he pull that off? Kellen Moore, his own miracle. Titus Young answers the prayer.
We talked about his arm strength. He's a better thrower than last year. He gives Young a chance. And Young just shows flat-out speed and comes up with it. It is a good catch. The ball did not hit the ground. How did they get it all done with a second left?
9 seconds on the snap. 1 second when he completes the diving catch. And a timeout called to try to set up the game-winning field goal. And now Kyle Brotsman, a former walk-on, a fourth-year starter who has had a record-breaking career, will come on to try to win this game.
Tess, in this situation, no one can get behind you. If you have to line up 30 yards deep, no one can get behind you. You just can't let anyone get behind you, even if you go stand back 30 yards.
Here's Brotsman. The officials
previous play is under further review.
Are going to take a look at Titus Young's ultimate highlight. The WAC replay official is Ken Lucido, and here's what he will be viewing.
Well, see, to me, the catch isn't an issue. He caught that ball and rolled over to show the ball without it hitting. I thought the only issue might be the clock.
Clock stopped with a second to go.
There's a catch, turns over. The ball never gets to the ground. His elbow and body are on the ground.
That is truly a magnificent play by Kellen Moore and Titus Young.
And the body control to turn his body to make sure that the ball did not come in contact with the ground.
Down with 2 seconds remaining. Clock operator, please reset the game clock to 2 seconds.
So he even saved an extra second.
Chris Peterson, yeah, I knew we'd have to put a second back on.
Titus Young was fully extended, both feet off the ground. And Kellen Moore, what have they said about Kellen Moore all year long? The biggest improvement.
Can't throw the deep ball. That's what they said last year.
That's right.
And that was the biggest jump this year. But again, you go back to that catch and that body control, making sure that Titus Young turned his body so the ball never came close to having contact with the ground, was all the difference in that catch being clearly a legal catch.
And now it comes down to the right foot of Kyle Brotsman.
Chris has to be sick. How can somebody with 9 seconds to go get behind your secondary?
Nation's active scoring leader. WAC special team player of the week. A senior. Now it's time for Brotsman to deliver. This from 26. Tessitore, Rod Gilmore, and David Diaz. And
okay, fellas, we'll now begin extra periods. Boise, you're going to call a toss. What's your call going to be?
Heads.
Okay. There's heads, there's tails. Here we go. hands first. You want to go in that direction? All right. So just stay right here. We'll go that way. First and 10.
So you heard the coin flip there as Nevada has the opportunity to know what they will need to accomplish in overtime. But how we have reached this point is amazing.
Well, just think about the emotional swing over the last couple of minutes. You're tied, you're down, you come up with a great big catch, and now you're going to win the game with the game-winning kick. You're set up for just a nice, easy field goal, right? Game win.
But Brotzman misses the 26-yarder. Boy, those shorter uprights, you know, most of the major universities have the longer uprights, but that is so tough to tell. But just slid out to the side on Kyle Brotzman, who is so greatly accomplished, and perhaps he will get another chance. But as it stands now, this stadium has come alive. Boise goes to offense first. Moore, good looking fake. He's incomplete. All right, so let's set the table for overtime here, Rob.
Well, you know the rules. Coin toss, a choice of offense, defense. Everybody wants to be on defense first so that you know what the other team has done. You know what you have to do. You get one possession from the 25-yard line. Keep going back and forth. Game clock doesn't matter. You must go for two, starting with the third overtime.
Prior to that incompletion, Moore's last two passes was the 79-yard screen pass touchdown and that miraculous 53-yarder to Young. Now second and 10. Looking to set up the screen, but being pursued. Had to wait for it. Now able to get it, but smashed down was Doug Martin by Kevin Grimes.
Well, it is the pressure from Nevada that is disrupting Boise State's passing attack. Moak and company are disrupting the rhythm and timing. Moore wanted to go to Pettis to the right side, but the pressure forced him to the left and he couldn't come back to Pettis.
Third and 9. Wide open was Avery for a first down for Boise.
Well, they mixed them up again. They caught them with the blitz coming inside, and instead of Avery staying inside to help, he snuck out to the right side.
16 yards on third and 9. And it'll be a first and goal here. There's Peterson. Pressure-packed situations. His team has not seen much of this. Play action. Moore. Back of the end zone, but Titus Young could not get a grasp of it.
He surveyed the field. His first choice was Kyle Efah. He wanted him in the middle of the field, but had to come off of that. And Pettis wasn't open. And then he finally goes back to his third option, Titus Young, in the back of the end zone. Pettis is his preferred guy down here.
Martin wrapped up in the backfield. Ryan Colson, the first to get on top of him.
Well, you know, the interesting thing is they took Young out and they took Pettis out and signaled the running play.
They did. Potter was in at receiver.
You know, their favorite play down here is to use Pettis and to use him on a slant to get that big body inside to give him a chance.
Martin and Avery both in on third and goal from the 12. Incomplete. Young got his hands up and the ball bounced into the end zone. So now Kyle Brotzman has to return to the field to kick again.
Well, you see him come back again, trying to get it over to Young. No, he's throwing at the coverage. Pettis was the guy he wanted. Marlon Johnson, great job inside. But Pettis, again, was doubled to the right side.
This from 29. This is turning into a disaster for Brotzman. He misses from 26, what could have been the game winner in regulation, and now in the first overtime, he misses from 29, and Nevada will have a chance to pull the upset.
Tess, both of these kicks have been straight on, no angle. And he pushed the one in regulation, and he hooked this one.
It'll be the signature moment for this program. By Tawa to the 21. Kellen Moore's reaction with a missed kick. Could these BCS dreams come crash down here in Reno?
It only takes a field goal for Nevada.
Any score and they win.
A loss would drop Boise State out of contention for the national championship and out of the Rose Bowl race.
TCU would stand alone as the highest non-AQ. Kaepernick. And that is incomplete. So it'll make for a 3rd and 6. So much on the line here. Remember, the day started with Alabama way out in front of Auburn, and people around the world of Boise State were thinking, could it be that we could be playing for a spot in the national title game? And then Oregon does their thing, the Auburn comeback, and they're thinking, okay, still alive with the hope, still alive for the Rose Bowl. And then the Nevada comeback after trailing 17-0.
Kaepernick will have to be smart, not take chances. They are already in position to attempt a field goal.
Keep it on the ground with Tawa. He muscles ahead inside the 20. So it is now the time for the redshirt freshman, the 5'6" Anthony Martinez, who joined the program as a walk-on. And now can give them their biggest win. This attempt from 34.
I expect a timeout from Chris Peterson.
Instead, it is Martinez with the win. Nevada has done it.
Second half, and Boise State was challenged into the fourth quarter, and they did not make the plays. Nevada made the plays in the fourth quarter.
Anthony Martinez. The moment of truth, and he delivers. And with that ball sailing into the cold, thin air of the High Sierras, Chris Ault, the Hall of Famer, wanted this so much. And for the other side, BCS hopes go into that thin air.
I am surprised that Boise State did not use a timeout to freeze Martinez before the kick.
Kellen Moore, who has had such a wonderful season and put his team in position with one of the great highlights you will see, the Titus Young diving catch. But Kyle Brotsman missing a 26-yard field goal at the end of regulation and then missing a 29-yard field goal in overtime. That opened the door for Nevada. Let's go down to the field to Dave Diaz-Infante. Dave?
Well, Coach, tell us the feeling that's going through your team right now and yourself after finally getting over the hump and defeating Boise State and clinching part of the WAC title.
David, it's just a thrill, you know. And right now, you're just trying to enjoy everything. I'm looking at those kids out in that field. Couldn't be prouder of them and the coaching staff to come back like we. I mean, this is a great thrill.
Coach, you talked about your defense having to make some stops. They're the ones that really got momentum going for you guys in the second half. How proud of you of their effort?
Well, I'm really proud of our defense, and you're right. They got us back into it. Then the offense caught going. We warmed down a little bit. That offense was really good, David, that second half.
Coach, what was going through your mind at the end of the game with all the things that transpired, the missed field goals, the big play at the end by Boise State, the gamut of emotions that went through your heart?
We're a team of destiny. It's going to happen now. When he missed that field goal, I said, this is it. We got it now, guys. Let's go.
Well, Coach, destiny was on your side tonight. Congratulations. It's one of the biggest wins in the history of your program.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
They storm the field. Garrett Mackey, biggest game that this stadium has ever hosted. The first time two ranked teams had ever met here. At number four, Boise was the highest ranked team to ever come to Nevada. An amazing Friday of college football, from the Auburn comeback to Oregon exploding to this ultimate classic soap opera thriller here in Reno, Rob.
It was an incredible playoff day, and you see the range of emotions you get with everything on the line. You had number one and number two and number four playing, number three watching, and everything coming down to tonight, a play here, a kick there, and now Boise State is off the radar for the national championship.
If everybody holds serve, we get an Oregon-Auburn national title game. TCU could be smelling roses. Mighty Boise has fallen, and this Wolfpack team is for real. 34-31 overtime win. Anthony Martinez sends it home. Kellen Moore, the disappointment. For Rod Gilmore and Dave Diaz-Infante, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us here in Reno. Enjoy the rest of your night.